Assalamu alaikum, students. This is concept number 3 on the Poisson distribution of statistics 2 9709 A level mathematics. Okay, so now we are going to talk about the concept number 3, that is basically when you have to do approximation for the normal approximation from the Poisson approximation. Okay, so you can write down that this is Poisson distribution approximation to normal distribution approximation. Okay, so this is the approximation, and that is what we are going to discuss now, Poisson distribution to the normal distribution. Okay, so hope everyone gets this concept number 3. Let's start. Okay, it's a 4-mark question, and what are the conditions, what are the criteria to get this. Okay, for 4 marks, let's read the question. Cars arrive, again this is October November 2019 past papers, topical past papers. Cars arrive at a filling station randomly and the constant average rate lambda is 2.4 per minute. Use a suitable approximating distribution to calculate the probability that at least 140 cars arrive in a 1 hour period. Okay, so 140 cars should be arriving in a 1 hour period. So students first need to understand that there is the interval is different. Okay, the interval is different. This is 2.4 cars per minute and they're asking for a 1 hour period. So the first thing will be you change your interval. You have x follows Poisson, that was 2.4 cars per minute. In 1 minute, 2.4 cars was going, so you already know that 1 hour is 60 minutes. Okay, very common thing. Okay, basic understanding. So it's going to be x follows Poisson, you multiply 60 with 2.4 and that will be your Poisson distribution. Then you, so x follows Poisson distribution now becomes 60 into 2.4, that is 144. Okay, so here we go, this is x follows Poisson distribution, 144 cars in 60 minutes, or you can write it as x follows Poisson distribution, 144 cars are going to arrive at the gas filling station in 1 hour. Okay, so 144 cars are going to arrive. So as I discussed in the concept number 1, that unit interval is very important. Up till now I haven't started the approximation, that is the Poisson to normal approximation. Students, I'm just doing the basic thing, that is changing the interval, that plays a very key important role here. Okay, so we are saying that in 1 minute there were 2.4 cars passing, now in 1 hour there will be 144 cars passing. Okay, so that is important. Now we can see that the lambda is large. Okay, so you need to understand, students, that we can see that our lambda is large, lambda is huge, that is 144, and the concept also says that when lambda is large, the distribution, the Poisson distribution, will take on the characteristic of the normal shape. That is basically the Poisson distribution will take the shape of a normal distribution, and that is why the concept becomes that the condition becomes if lambda is greater than 15. Okay, so if the lambda, this is scientifically proving, mathematical models have proved that if the lambda value is greater than 15, generally you assume that if the lambda value is greater than 15, it will give reasonable results. Okay, the larger the value of lambda will be, the better the approximation will be. So here we can say that 144 lambda, that is the value of the Poisson distribution mean, it is large, it is huge. So when x follows Poisson distribution as lambda, so it can be approximated to x follows the normal distribution, that will be lambda as mean and lambda as well as the variance as well. Okay, very important fact to understand. Students need to understand very carefully that the mean and variance are same. Okay, the mean and the variance for the Poisson distribution are same. Everyone needs to know this concept. The mean is lambda as well as the variance is also lambda, right? The mean and variance are lambda for the Poisson distribution. So students need to understand that x follows normal distribution as well will be the mean and variance. We will also have that the lambda will be the same. Okay, the lambda value will be same. So you can say that x was following a Poisson distribution with 144 as the lambda. Now x is converted to approximated, you say approximated x from Poisson distribution, you approximate to normal distribution, where we say that the mean is lambda and the variance will be mean as well. Okay, variance will be the lambda as well. Okay, so here we go, Now, the main important thing, students, let's write it down. So x follows a normal distribution, that is with 144, 144 as the mean and variance, okay? 144 and 144 as the mean and variance. The next important thing will be the continuity correction. Students need to understand that why there will be a continuity correction. Yes, there will be a continuity correction. There will be no continuity correction in binomial and Poisson approximation because both of them are the discrete distribution. Okay, both of them are discrete distribution. But when we talk about, students, the normal approximate, the Poisson to normal, you are yourself saying that it is a continuous, normal is a continuous distribution, and we will have to do the continuity correction because you are going from a discrete to continuity correction. Okay, you are going from a discrete distribution to a continuous distribution. Okay, I'll repeat my point clear to for students to be clear. Poisson distribution is a discrete distribution. You are going from Poisson to the normal distribution, that is a continuous distribution. So you'll have to apply the continuity correction. And what is continuity correction? From the S1 concept, you should remember or visit the S1 lectures that it is basically 0.5 added or subtracted. Okay, it is plus 0.5 added or subtracted based on the question. And you don't have to remember this, you just have to do with the logic. So what we are requirement? Our requirement is that we have to find the probability of at least 140 cars arrive in a 1 hour period. So it will be that probability of at least to one, at least means greater than and equals to at least 140 cars arriving at a 1 hour period. Okay, it will be 140 cars greater than equals to. So let's just make the diagram for this and understand. Okay, so here we go. It will be very simple, students, and you'd have to have the MF9 formula as well. So there we go. This is our going to be mean. Okay, that is 144. And what will be the value that we are going to look for, students? The value that we are going to look for will be, because it is x is greater than equals to 140, so you can write that this could be probability of x is greater than 139 as well. Okay, it's the same thing. Probability of x is greater than 139 cars, or probability of x is greater than or equals to 140 cars, is the same thing. So you can say that the continuity correction will be 0.5 subtracted here. So it will be x is greater than 139.5. Okay, so you are going to subtract 0.5 from here, students. So here we go. You are going to have 139.5 from here, and you will have to find the probability for this region, for this part. Rest of the calculation is just normal distribution, the basic normal distribution that you do. So here we go, students, let's work it out. It's going to be the z value, that is x minus the mean divided by the standard deviation. So I have z value as 139.5 minus 140 minus 144 as the mean value divided by standard deviation, that is 144. Okay, so here we go, students, I got the z value as, make sure in your calculator you do this, 139.5 minus 144 divided by square root of 144. So I'm going to get as negative 0.375. Okay, students. So let's write down that probability of Z is minus 0.375. You would not get the answer, for Z is negative 0.375. Students need to understand that this will be here 0.375 negative. So eventually it is saying that probability, we have to find probability of Z is greater than minus 0.375. So as we know the concept from the S1, it will be probability of Z is less than 0.375. That will be exactly same here, from here to here, that we are going to find, students. So Z value is basically positive 0.375 that you are going to look for, because negative Z value is not there in the MF9 table. I'll repeat it. You have to just do it simple S1 concepts from here onwards. Make sure continuity correction, students, do not forget that. Okay, you have to apply continuity correction. Why it is 0.5 subtracted? Because you look at that, what is the other way possible to write this down? We needed probability of at least 140 cars, which means the same thing, that minimum, kamaskam 140 cars. And you can go beyond that, 141, 142, 143. And so basically we said that what is the other possible probability of X is greater than 139. Okay, now let's look at 0.375 Z value there. So here we go, 0.37. Make sure there will be no Z value, because the probability that the table gives are less than. So here we go, 0.37 and 5, okay? So you can say 0.6443 plus 19, so 0.6443 plus 0.0019. So I'm getting it as 0.646, okay, students? So here we go. The answer is going to come as 0.646 as the final answer, students. Sorry, the space is not there because I was explaining. So that's all the concepts. It's a 4-mark question, but because I was explaining, so I've given all the things in detail. Make sure you start off by making the interval same, okay? You need to make interval same. We'll discuss more questions on concept number 3, so stay tuned to the channel, and hope everyone got this Poisson distribution approximation to normal distribution approximation. Where n is large, where the lambda will be large is not a problem. Where lambda is actually greater than 15 or it is large, you can do the normal distribution approximation, students.